Who else does you and love me do? And another figure from the far-flung past has joined us.
Thank you.
Good morning, Midjour.
Good morning.
Now, look, I have a lot of stuff in praise of you. And Normski is a great pal of this programme, great Tog and Helen. The great pleasure of meeting Midjour when he recorded the Bandaged album, I remember, which the Togs did, on the Beatles classic, All You Need Is Love. A nicer man you couldn't wish to meet.
Ah, well, I'm sure they probably met the wrong guy.
An unsolicited testimonial, though. You can't beat it. And there are people with their eye on you. Ormsky says, it looks like Midjour will be out on tour for most of 2015, from Halifax, Nova Scotia, to Inverness in Old Scotia, and all points in between. He's off to Poland by thunder and playing down under, because he's a man on the go. We can all smile. He's parked for a while to appear today on your show. Here you are.
That's really good. That's excellent.
And they know plenty about you as well. You're all over the place.
I am all over the place. I'm still out there singing for my supper.
Is it the money?
No, you know what? I remember having a conversation with Mr. Geldof, and
he's not a man who spends foolishly.
No, he does not. He's a man with no pockets, and and we talked about what we would do other than doing this, and we're not skilled at anything, so this is good enough.
Yes, of course, you'll always be associated with Bob and your great work for Live Aid and Live 8. And you're going to be singing your new single for us. Tell us about this new album. 10 years. Why does it take you so long?
Did it take you that long
to write a song?
A lot of twiddling of thumbs, I think. Uh-huh. 10 years. It wasn't 10 years of pondering as to what to do. I went through a massive phase of wondering whether I still wanted to be part of this record industry, what's left of it, because it seems to have changed so much in a very short space of time. But then I gave myself a clip round the ear and just said, get on with it. So I finally finished the album that I'd been working on.
Yeah, I don't blame you. It is confusing, isn't it? Because, I mean, Tony Blackburn will tell you there's a top 10, a top 20, but there isn't really anymore, is there?
Well, there's no physical object, which is really odd. You know, it's very strange to try and find, you know, a single used to be something that you could hold in your hand. You know, now it just floats in the ether. I'm not sure what it is anymore.
And you had 10 solo singles and all sorts of success. I mean, No Regrets, If I Was. So this new tour, February...
Yeah,
you're ready to go, are you?
Kind of. I haven't rehearsed and routined the band yet, but I know these guys and they're supersonically talented, so I'm really looking forward to getting out there and getting my teeth into some of these songs again.
Good. You're going to sing two for us, because nobody gets it for free here. Is this a new one?
This is the new one, yeah. This is going to be the next single from the album Fragile.
When will that be out?
It's going to be out early March, 2nd of March, I believe.
Well, we count the hours.
Thank you. How long must I wait to find one dream to dream on? Just whispers from my radio to paint my life in shades of black and white. How low must I fall to find one dream to dream on? Oh, this dark, dark night. Sheer out of hope, cried out of tears. What's left but all my nothings? My life tied up in silken threads. Out of time, it's all for nothing. Oh, 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 oh. How long must I wait to find something to lean on?
just whispers from my radio to paint my life in shades of black and white. How low must I fall to find one dream to dream on? Oh, 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 this dark, dark night. How long must I wait to find one dream to dream on? Just whispers from my radio to paint my life in shades of black and white. How low must I fall to find one dream to dream on? Oh, 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 this dark, dark night. Oh, 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 this dark, dark night.
Major, and that's the single from his new CD, Fragile. And I'm sure they're all as good as that.
Thank you very much.
Good. Now, you spent a huge part of your career as part of a band from Thin Lizzy to Ultravox.
Yeah.
So, does that differ from being a solo musician? I mean, I know you've been solo for a long time now, but...
You know what? Being in a band is fantastic. It's wonderful. You know, when you're creating something, it's fabulous when it's all going well, because... You know, when you get to a point in a recording where you think, I'm not quite sure where to take this, someone else steps in and takes over. When you're on your own, you really are on your own. So the new album, I've done everything myself. I engineered it, I played the instruments, I mixed it, the whole thing. And maybe that's why it takes such a long time to do, because there's no one to go, here, your turn now, you know.
Yeah, so, and of course you were involved with Band Aid 30.
I was, yeah. Well, it was a lovely thing. I have to say, it was great working with, you know, the new guys. You know, Ed Sheeran, such a talented lad. It's fantastic. And it got me huge brownie points with my daughters, who love Ed Sheeran, when he came over and kissed me on the head. They, all of a sudden, I was special because I know Ed Sheeran.
Were you pleased with the whole thing?
I was. I think there was a funny, kind of weird media backlash about it that nobody saw coming. Saying that song was a strange song. It's not as though the song was new. You know, the song's been around for 30 years, so I can't see why it would be a surprise to someone what the song actually was. But the bottom line is, there's a couple of million pounds there that's raised so far that is already being allocated and spent in West Africa on various projects. So that's the bottom line, really.
Was it good to get together with Bob again?
You know what, Bob and I are always connected, even though we don't see each other for ages. We have a weird text relationship. You know, Bob texts me, but he texts like a 14-year-old, you know, in youth speak, and I answer him with punctuation and everything, and of course his just fly at you, and mine take ages to write with my thumb. So we have this lovely relationship going. He's a great guy.
So Band Aid singles are always followed by huge events, Live Aid, Live 8. Do you think there's going to be a live concert?
A couple of months prior to the Band Aid 30 record happening, there was absolutely no plans to make the record. In fact, there were plans not to do it, and circumstances changed, and we were asked to do it, so we did. Right now, hand on heart, there are no plans whatsoever to do any 30th anniversary celebratory concerts. Putting a concert together of that kind of magnitude, it's a huge, huge business. So I will let you know first if it happens.
Yeah, but you won't keep a seat for me, oh no. I'll be standing at the back as usual.
We'll charge you. I mean, what, you're Bob's Irish and I'm Scottish. What can I tell you?
Look, do you know I expected that? Janet says, a nice guy, that Midyear. You see, another unsolicited testimonial. You've been fooling them for a long time. Yeah, met him in a pub in Socky Hall Street in 1978. He was gigging with another friend, and my friend and I were part of an audience of about 8 people. And they came and had a drink with us.
It's amazing how some things never change. Still the same 8 people coming to see me.
And so they should. So they should, because you're worth listening to. You're going to sing one of your all-time favourites for
us. An oldie. I mean, we're rapidly heading towards Valentine's Day, and this is a very romantic tune.
If I was.
If I was, yeah.
If I was a better man, would fellow men take me to their hearts? If I was a stronger man, carrying the weight of popular demand, tell me, would that alarm her? I'd never harm her at all. If I was a soldier, captive on sight, lay before her. If I was a sailor, seven oceans I'd sail to her. If I was a wiser man, would other men reach out and touch me? If I was a kinder man, dishing up love for a hungry world, tell me, would that appease you? I want to please you again. If I was a poet, all my love in burning words, I would show it. If I was a painter, I'd paint a world that could not taint her. Oh, come here, my baby. Oh, they can't touch you now. I'll keep you safe and warm. I'd never leave you at all. Come here, my baby. Oh, they can't touch you. Dishing up love for a hungry world. Tell me, would that appease you? 'Cause I want to please you again. If I was a soldier, captive on sight, lay before her. If I was a sailor, I'd sail to her. If I was her leader, on food of love from above, I would feed her. If I was her lover, her eyes in kisses,
timeless and ageless. Midjour.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for coming in.
A pleasure.
My tears are falling 'cause you've taken her away.